Well, with 1,500 members, the Rebels is Australia's largest outlaw motorcycle gang operating in every state and territory. It is the target of a national task force run by 14 law enforcement agencies to smash its illegal activities. Now, since February, they've made more than 330 arrests, leading to more than 500 charges relating to violence, also stalking, kidnapping, assault, drugs and weapons offences. Task Force Attero aims to target and investigate the criminal activity of the Rebels. The lessons learnt will be applied to efforts to tackle other motorcycle gangs. Well, joining me now from Melbourne is Attero National Task Force member and New South Wales Deputy Police Commissioner David Hudson. Deputy Commissioner, you've described the Rebels gang as Australia's highest risk criminal threat. Why have they been targeted ahead of perhaps other equally violent bikie gangs?
Thank you. There's a number of reasons we've targeted the Rebels outlaw motorcycle gang. Firstly, because they have a presence within every state and territory within Australia. But secondly, and perhaps more importantly, because of the level of criminality that they engage in. Through the task force, we have identified numerous incidents of criminality, including drug distribution, drug manufacture, drug importation, violence offences, extortion offences. Since the task force commenced on the 1st of February this year, we have charged over 330 members of the Rebels Outlaw Motorcycle Gang.
And that equates to roughly, if they've got a 1,500 odd membership, one-fifth of the group. Is that enough to genuinely disrupt their operations? Because notoriously these groups plan for these sorts of arrests and then very quickly renew their criminal activities.
Yeah, that's very true. We think we've had a significant impact not only on the existing members but also on preventing people to join the club. These clubs exist for one purpose, and that's to engage in criminal activity.
Deputy Commissioner, we know that the business model for bikies is changing, if we could call it that, modernising. Is it the case that these criminals are increasingly infiltrating legitimate business now?
Certainly that's the case. We have very clear evidence that certain industries are being targeted by the Rebels and other outlaw motorcycle gangs to try and legitimise their interests and launder their illicit activities, or the money gained from their illicit activities.
I've got to ask you as well, is it the case when authorities focus their attention on one criminal group, one bikie group, that perhaps another is allowed to flourish? We've seen in New South Wales four Comanchero bikies shot this week, one of them fatally. Are we on the brink perhaps here of a bikie war?
Look, the conflict in New South Wales and the involvement of Comancheros is currently under investigation. There is no way that the focus has been taken away from other outlaw motorcycle gangs or other criminal entities or groups.
New South Wales Deputy Police Commissioner David Hudson, thank you for joining us tonight.
Thank you.